when the genocide started, they started to kill people of my tribe. My parents sent me to hide to a neighbor who was from the other tribe. I went to him and he put me to sit in this bathroom. It was during the day when I got there, and then the next morning about 3 o'clock, he came and took me and showed me through the house with a torch, and then he showed me this tiny bathroom in his bedroom and he put me to sit there. I'm thinking, this is too small for me. What am I going to do here? Because you think, what have I done to deserve this anyway? You know, I'm just a student. And everybody loved me and I loved them. And there was nothing I can ever feel guilty about. And I'm thinking, here, this is a prison. So he went back, brought 5 more women. In the beginning were 6. The youngest was 7 years old. He went later, he brought 2 more women. We were 8 people, sitting on the top of each other. The bathroom was 3 by 4 feet, small. 8 of us for 3 months. For 3 months, one time they came to hunt for us. The killers hired by the government, fed by the government and drinks. And one guy stood outside. I can hear him. He went to school with me, primary school. And he spoke and he said, I have killed 399 cockroaches. That's how he called us. And he said, I want Immaculate to be the 400. That would be a good number. And I'm thinking, somebody lost their mind? They don't remember that I'm a human being? What have happened to him? This is a man I would call a friend in a normal time, like when we were going to school. He was just a normal person. And he found the 400 person to kill and more. It can make you go crazy. You just want to tell them, like, it's me. It was bad, like in my mind I was so angry. My skin was just burning, like you are on fire. So angry and so fearful at the same time. They came searching in the ceiling of the house. They came under the beds, the closets. It was completely the grace of God that we did not find that bathroom. And I remember when I was saying our Lord's Prayer, and I remember reaching to that part that said, forgive us as we forgive those who trespass against us. And all of a sudden, it was almost like a picture of all the killers was in front of me. Thousands, if not millions. And it was almost like Jesus was telling me, pray for them to change instead of hating them. Are you going to be like them? Are you going to do what you hate most, which is the genocide, the hatred? Are you going to do that? Or are you going to try to change them? So then I started to pray for them. It made all the sense. Truly, truly, there is a potential in every human being, in the worst person who have done the worst thing, there's a potential to be an angel. It is not poverty, our worst enemy. Our worst enemy is the truth that is not truth. It is the lies that are in our hearts that another person is less than another. Only through love, our country can get back together.